welcome to Cycle 5, Week 5. I'm so excited that you're with us. Are you getting your stamps? I bet you are. I bet you're doing a really great job. Open up your book to its Bible section, and we have Julian and Sarah Kate and Lauren, and they're all in our Reston campus. And on the other side, we have Kelly and Liam, and Kelly's in Reston, and Liam is in Bealton campus. They are all really, really cool kids. All right, so the Bible verse is, "But if anyone has the world's goods and sees his brother in need, yet he closes his heart against him, how does God's love abide in him?" So if you see someone in need and you're like, "Eh, I don't care, I'm going to close my heart against him," then God says, how does God's love abide in him? How does God's love live in him? Because God puts it on our heart to take care of those in need. And so it's really important that we remember to take care of those people who are in need, because that's what God wants us to do. That's a heart that God has given us. So in our instructions, it said, do you have an abundance of toys or other things that you could share with others? How about your siblings? Do you share with your siblings? Like for reals? I don't know. Ask your mom. All right. And then it says, draw a picture of you blessing others by giving to them. Can you draw a picture of you blessing others? Because I bet you are a huge blessing to many people. I bet you are. All right. The next one is, welcome to the Roaring Twenties, a time when many had plenty of pennies. It was the birth of jazz music and the radio and movies to use it. Many moved from country to city, leaving nature behind for the fast-paced and gritty. The 19th century gave women the right to vote. The suffragettes set their dreams afloat. So do you remember back to Susan B. Anthony, our second timeline card? Did you write suffragette in there? That's right. She was a suffragette. She tried to get the right for the women to vote. And remember, Susan B. Anthony died in 1903, but in 1920, the 19th Amendment was finally passed, and we got the right to vote. So the Roaring Twenties was a time when there was lots of money going around in America, and people were just enjoying it. But they were probably enjoying it too much. So remember when we talked about hyperinflation last week? Remember that? Well, what was happening in America, like for reals? I don't know. Ask your mom. All right. And then it says, draw a picture of you blessing others by giving to them. Can you draw a picture of you blessing others? Because I bet you are a huge blessing to many people. I bet you are. All right. The next one is, we're finally done with World War I. I was getting so tired of World War I. But the next one is, welcome to the Roaring Twenties, a time when many had plenty of pennies. It was the birth of jazz music and the radio and movies to use it. Many moved from country to city, leaving nature behind for the fast-paced and gritty. The 19th century gave women the right to vote. The suffragettes set their dreams afloat. So do you remember back to Susan B. Anthony, our second timeline card? Did you write suffragette in there? That's right. She was a suffragette. She tried to get the right for the women to vote. And remember, Susan B. Anthony died in 1903, but in 1920, the 19th Amendment was finally passed, and we got the right to vote. So the Roaring Twenties was a time when there was lots of money going around in America, and people were just enjoying it. But they were probably enjoying it too much. So remember when we talked about hyperinflation last week? Remember that? Well, what was happening in America is we have the stock market. A stock market is where companies sell shares of themselves. So if you are a cookie making company and you have 5 employees, but you could get, if you had 10 employees, if you could hire 10 employees, instead of making $1,000 a month, you could make $3,000 a month, because those 10 employees could make it go so much faster. So you go to some people and you say, look, I make these wonderful cookies. They're paleo, gluten-free, you know, all of that. And I want to make my business bigger. So the people say, well, I'll tell you what, if you give me 3% of your company, or you give me a little bitty percent of your company, I will give you the money to hire these extra employees for a year. And you go, yay! So you hire the extra employees, and your company does even better than you anticipated. And so you give the person back some money, a percentage of the profits of how much come into your company. And so they profit from it, and they still hold a piece of your company, and they profit from it every year because the stock goes up. And then they can sell the stock, and they can get some more profit from it, or they can get the dividends is what you would give them as a profit from it. So basically, it's you're selling little parts of your company. And so in the 1920s, this was a big deal. A lot of people were doing it, and a lot of people were getting lots and lots of money from it. Well, kind of, because they were buying their stocks on margin. So let's go through what margin is. Margin is when you say, basically, I'm going to go to the bank, or I'm going to go to someone, and I'm going to get a loan so that I can buy my stocks. And then when the stocks go up, I'll sell parts of them and I'll pay back my loan. And so when you do a margin like that, when you buy on margin, you have to have collateral. So we'll put these words up. You're buying on margin, you have to have collateral. Collateral is like a house, or a car, or your furniture. Collateral is anything that you own that's a hard asset. So put up collateral equals hard asset, or gold, or something like that. So people said, okay, look, I'll say that my house is worth $100,000, and I'm going to get a margin loan of $100,000 so that I can buy the stock, so that I can get the money from the stock, so I can make a lot of money. And guess what? They made a ton of money. They made a ton of money for a long time. Like, it seemed like everyone would make money doing this. It seemed like it would keep on going forever, and it was great. And people bought fancy cars and big houses, and they had big parties, and they had lots of jewelry, and they had lots and lots and lots and lots of stuff. And then everyone goes this. Dun, 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 dum. Can everyone do that? Dun, 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 dum. The stock market crashed in 1929. And guess what? All of a sudden, all those people that the other people had gotten margins on, that they had gotten the loans from, they called their margins, meaning they said, oh, we want everything back. We want the money we lent you back today. And there was no way with the stock market crashing that the people could do that. So it meant that the banks took their houses, their cars, their furniture, their jewelry, all of their money, all of their gold. They took everything. And people who had been wealthy and extremely rich and driving around in fancy cars with fancy everything and maids and servants and all that kind of stuff, the next day, some of them were destitute and they had nothing. And so we're going to discuss that, but I wanted you to kind of get those terms in your head, because we need to make sure that we really understand what margins are about and what loans are about. Even in kindergarten, this is important to understand, because we don't want to go down that road. All right, so that was a very long story, and it says, so we're going to learn about budgeting this week. Really cool stuff. And it says, pretend you earn $100 each month, and you need $20 for food, $30 for rent, $10 for gas, $10 for electricity, and you have $30 left over. How would you spend it? Would you save anything? Draw a picture of the things that you would purchase with the extra $30. And keep in mind those people of the Roaring Twenties. Keep in mind that they spent like crazy. And it probably didn't do them any good. All right, next is geography. The Czech Republic, Slovakia, Hungary, Romania, Belarus, Moldova, and Russia surround Ukraine. Hey! So we're going to need that for our next couple of weeks, so make sure you memorize that. And we are ready for our timeline cards. Are you ready? All right.